In this lecture, we're going to discuss what is meant by concentration. When we talk about concentration, and this is term is would be used when we're referring to solutions, or it could be used for gases as well. But in moles and stoichiometry, generally this term concentration is specifically used for solutions. So now, what do we mean by concentration? We're very familiar with the term more concentrated or less concentrated. What that means is that if a solution is more concentrated, I have two beakers in front of me, and they have water. It has both beakers have water in it. They are particles of let's say a salt suspended in both of these beakers. So I mixed a salt in both of the beakers, and one of them is more concentrated. So you can by looking at the amount of particles in this volume, in this particular beaker, the first beaker, you can easily figure out that this one is more concentrated. Whereas the other one, the second beaker, there are fewer particles, they are far apart, they have wide distances between them. So the particles are suspended so that they are less concentrated compared to the first one. So this beaker is less concentrated. And there's a term that is very frequently used for such a solution, that is that it's a dilute solution. That means that there is more water and there are less particles of that particular salt suspended in it. So what do we mean by the term concentrated? We can easily figure out by just looking at the two beakers which one is more concentrated. So when we refer to the term concentration, so whenever we mention this term concentration, what we mean is that it's the amount of particles. So it's the amount of particles per unit volume. So in a particular amount of volume, so per unit volume. So it's the amount of particles that is present in a specific volume of solution. If the amount of particles is large, that means it's more concentrated. So, and if the amount of particles is less, that means it's less concentrated. So we can derive a formula for concentration, which would be, so concentration would basically be equal to the amount of particles. This amount of particles is calculated in moles. You count the particles in moles. So it would be concentration would be equal to moles over volume. So volume in stoichiometry is generally taken in dm cube. So volume, the unit for volume would always be dm cube. So concentration is basically moles over volume. So that's your formula that you would use for solutions. And the unit for concentration would be moles over volume. So it would be mole per dm cube. So this is the unit that you would use for concentration, because moles has a unit of mole, mol. Volume would have a unit of dm cube. So the unit for concentration is going to be mole per dm cube. And this formula would be used. I will also refer to converting if the volume is given in cm cube. So if the volume is given in cm cube, you should know how to convert that into dm cube. And that is done by dividing by 1000. So for example, if you're given 100 cm cube, divide that by 1000 and you would get the same volume in dm cube, which would become 0.1 dm cube. So I'm going to do this conversion, and I'm also going to talk about meter cube. So meter cube is that if you divide dm cube again by 1000, you'll get the same volume in meter cube. And vice versa, if you're given volume in meter cube and you want to convert that into dm cube, then you're going to multiply that by 1000. And if you want to convert your dm cube volume in dm cube into cm cube, again you're going to multiply by 1000. So remember these conversions of volume. So your unit in your particular case should always be in dm cube when you're using formulas for moles. So I'm going to highlight the formula. This here is my formula. And this formula is going to be used for calculating moles for solutions. In this lecture, I'm going to try and solve a few questions using the formula that we discussed for solutions, which is concentration is equal to moles over volume. Now, I'm going to try and find moles, and I would be given a description of a particular solution. So the first question is about HCl aqueous. And what I'm given is that it says that it's 100 cm cube of 0.2 mole per dm cube HCl aqueous, and I need to find out the moles. Now, the first thing is I need to figure out which one is volume. So this over here represents volume, and the reason I was able to figure out the 100 cm cube as volume is because of its unit. It's cm cube is a unit for volume, and mole per dm cube is a unit for concentration. So by looking at the unit, I was able to figure out which one is concentration, which one is volume. Now, if I know the volume of HCl and the concentration of HCl, and I can now figure out moles. So the concentration of HCl is given out to be, it's given to be 0.2 mole per dm cube. So that is my concentration for HCl, and the moles, that's not given. So that's the unknown quantity divided by volume, which is 100 cm cube. And that should be divided by 1000 so that the volume comes in dm cube. You get the unit right. And I'm going to solve this formula now for, and I'm going to try and find moles. And my moles is going to come out to be, it's going to be 0.2 multiplied by 0.1, and that would come out to be 0.02 moles. So that's the moles that I have in this particular solution. Let's do another question, another example. And this time I have 1500 cm cube. So that here, this over here is my volume. And the concentration of the solution is 1.5 mole per dm cube. So this is concentration. And to find the moles of sodium phosphate aqueous, I just need to use this formula. So the concentration is 1.5 mole per dm cube, and it would be moles divided by volume, which in this case is 1500 cm cube again. So I need to convert that into dm cube by dividing it by 1000. So this would give the volume in decimeter cube, and then I need to solve for moles, and this would be 1.5 multiplied by 1.5. So my moles in this particular question, they are going to come out to be equal to 2.25 moles. In this lecture, we're going to do a few more examples using for the formula concentration is equal to moles over volume. And this time we're going to try and find out the concentration of a particular solution given a descriptive information about that solution. So in this particular case, in question number A, I have 0.5 moles of HCl, and the volume of the solution is also given. So the volume of the solution is 500 cm cube. So I'm going to use the formula for concentration. So concentration equals moles, which in this case is 0.5 moles, divided by volume, which in this case is 500 cm cube, and it should be divided by 1000 because you want the volume to be in dm cube. And solving for concentration using a calculator, the answer that you're going to get is 1, and the unit that you're going to get is 1 mole per dm cube. So concentration has a unit of mole per dm cube. So this solution has a concentration of 1 mole per dm cube. Let's do the second question. I have 20 moles of NaOH in 1500 cm cube solution. So the concentration is equal to moles, which in this case is 20 moles, divided by volume, which is 15,000 cm cube, and it should be in dm cube. So I'm going to divide that by 1000, so that would give the volume in dm cube, and the answer I'm going to get is 20 moles divided by 15, which is equal to 1 rounding to three significant figures is going to be 1.33 mole per decimeter cube. And looking at the concentration, you can easily figure out that HCl has a lower concentration, is more diluted. It only has a concentration of 1 mole per dm cube, whereas NaOH has a concentration of 1.33 mole per dm cube, which is higher compared to HCl. In this lecture, we're going to try and now find the volume of a solution using the formula concentration is equal to moles over volume. And what we would be given is the concentration and the number of moles of that particular solution. So in the first question, part A, I have 0.2 mole per dm cube NaOH, so that is my concentration. And I have a total moles of 0.015 moles of NaOH in that particular solution. So I need to find the volume. So using the formula concentration, which is 0.2 mole per decimeter cube, which is equal to moles over volume. So my moles are 0.015 moles. And my volume is unknown, so I would solve for volume. So it's going to be 0.015 divided by 0.2. So my volume comes out to be equal to 0.075 dm cube. And let's do part B now. It's exactly the same method. So I have been given concentrations. The solution is H3PO4. So I have 1.5 mole per dm cube of H3PO4. And that solution has 20 moles of H3PO4, so the concentration is 1.5 mole per decimeter cube, which is equal to moles over volume. So the moles is 20 moles, and the volume is unknown, and I would solve for volume, and the volume would come out to be equal to, it would come out to be equal to 20 moles divided by 1.5, and that gives me, rounding off to three significant figures, that's going to be 13.3 decimeter cube.